I'm here with Leroy, guys. Hi, Leroy.
Hey, what's up?
Oh, God, me. Well, me and him met on the dance floor. It was simple as that. It was just at the bar in a club in Essex where we met, really, all of us. And we were both just dancing and started having rocking with each other.
Yeah.
And a few tunes later, it sort of stopped, and I'm like, right, I'm Keith. I'm Leroy. And that was it. And then we just used to go out every weekend together, raving, checking out places all over the country, you know. So, little Flinty.
Yeah, so we can say the beginning was the dance.
Dance floor.
Dance floor.
First place I ever met him, yeah. Oh, for me, it was James Brown, really. He just used to move his feet so fast. And I was into soul and funk and everything, and then hip-hop before sort of the house and dance thing come along. So I was always into going out to clubs or parties where everyone danced. It was just a natural thing to follow it on with the electronic music, you know. But James Brown, James Brown for me. But,
James Brown, great.
There's been some in England, quite a few actually. And, well, it's funny because my daughter is going through a few of them, you know. So it's like a circle, a big circle of, you know, like I say, her doing things that I was doing. But I don't think, I think it's cool, but I don't think it'll ever be the same. Is it? It's not me, is it?
It's you. No, it's you. It's you.
Don't worry. So it's been
So the rave is not coming as it was back in the day?
Well, no, I don't think it'll ever be the same, ever. Because it was fresh then, and there was ecstasy involved, and everyone was on the same buzz. The DJs and the people producing music knew what they were doing with it. It was, well, I want to make music that's going to make the crowd who are high on ecstasy either get higher, like a euphoric feeling, or with pianos and good vocals and the word love and stuff, or make them bring their eyebrows down with a hard bass line and a bit of ragga stuff or some really hard techno sounds. And there was a communication or an understanding a lot more, which I don't think will ever come again, unless, well, I say that, but I don't think it will. I think it was so raw and so original.
Yeah.
That to be the first people to experience that, it was underground, it wasn't commercial, so I can't see it ever happen. Not in this style of music.
Yeah.
It might happen in a totally different scene, but, you know, I think even now the music has become sort of stale, the electronic music. You know, it's anyone can do it, everything now. Anyone can DJ because of technology, you know, in their bedroom. Back in the day when we were, Liam was doing the music and all the other producers, you were lucky if you got in a studio, you know. You had this little home set up with little sequencers and random stuff, MIDI stuff, none of the digital stuff, audio that we've got now.
Yeah.
And you had to record it onto that. And if you were lucky, you could get into a studio to mix it down and things like that. And everything seemed a bit more precious to get to the end.
Yeah.
Whereas now it's kind of, oh, just take that sound from anywhere or whatever. Whereas before you had records and you didn't have online, you couldn't just go, right, I want a kick drum and have 20,000 kick drums come up. You know, you had to find your stuff.
Yeah.
So, I think the people, when we were writing music, and when it come along, people have been listening to songs before that. you know, disco was clubby, you had different stuff that worked in clubs, punk, the jam, the mod stuff, soul, and that. But at the time, it was still song-based music, you know, big chorus, hooks, and we still grew up on that, and we kind of, I think, had that in our heads a lot more than they do now, that you've got to have a chorus.
Yeah,
because all the best songs in the world you remember, there's a reason they're the best song, or they're the reason that they get stuck in your head. Yeah. There's a formula, you know, there's a formula to music. You know, I don't like, I'll hear Britney Spears and it really annoys me, but it works because it's in my head. Yeah, because there's a formula to writing music. Not everyone can do it, but, you know, if you look at the Beatles or anything like that, you know, Please Please Me, there's always a chorus, there's a hook, there's a bit you remember.
Yeah.
And that's what old dance music used to have. And new dance music, the kids are more worried about how their snare drum sounds.
Yeah.
Whether, you know, than if someone's going to remember the song.
Because there are a lot of snare drums. They get a choice.
Yeah, but it's like, you can make that snare drum sound perfect in your studio at home, but every single sound system is different.
Yeah, exactly.
You know?
It's like photography in a way.
Yeah, and then as soon as you put it on any platform online, it's going to compress it, squash it, and change it.
Yeah.
You know, so how about worrying about, does your song make people dance? Not is a snare drum.
Yeah,
that was my last sort of official gig, really. That was 99, I think.
Yeah, 99. I still got the ticket.
and then I got back on stage 2005, I think it was, when they done the Greatest Hits album.
In Brixton Academy.
Yeah. It was like, come do a few gigs and that. I don't know. And then come, just do one, and if you're up for it, we'll do a few more, you know?
Yeah.
So I said, and I come down and I've done one show. And don't get me wrong, it was a buzz in terms of, nobody knew I was doing it, so when I come out on stage, the reaction was crazy, you know.
Yeah.
No one could believe it.
Yeah.
So that was a good buzz on that, but for the rest of it, for me, it was just like, man, it's like, I haven't done this for over five years, and then it's exactly the same. You know, it's like, man, you know, I can't dance to them old songs anymore.
Yeah.
You know, I can't, there's nothing else I can do with my body that I haven't done it to that. Then sit out of space, start the dance. Like, yeah, but they're your tunes, man. Like, yeah, but man, I just can't do one of the old tunes that Keith used to dance to. Then I really get a buzz out of it because it's something fresh for me, you know?
Yeah.
At night. Afterwards, it was like, man, what do you think? They say, it's a job for tomorrow. And I'm like, nah, man, that's it. I've done two albums in lockdown, which are kind of concept albums, about an hour long, 20 songs on each, and I've written all the tracks, and it's like a mix album, really, but it'll go from funk to hip-hop to techno to reggae to disco. All the music I like, you know. It was like, I'm not DJing, so I'm not going to write music to DJ with because no one's DJing. So I'll just do something different. Don't want to sound bad, but I'm not over DJing, but I want to write music that's more than like 3 months, everyone plays it and then nobody hears it again. You know, to me that's no point.
Yeah.
You know, I want to write a song that someone can play in 10 years' time. You know, that's what you're trying to do. Not say, oh yeah, that was a dubstep tune, I don't play dubstep. Or that's in that sort of tune. I don't play that. I don't want to write music that fits anywhere. It's just rocks, and if you like it, if I want to do it fast, I'll do it fast. I want to do it slow, I'll do it slow. I don't want it. I want it to be my music. That's it. I don't care about trying to fit in anyway.
Great.
You know, and so yeah, I'm really hoping, fingers crossed. I've started putting some of that this out already, but the next album I'll do like a proper album, 10 or 12 tracks or something. I've got a vocalist, really special vocalist. I kind of want to make a platform around the album, 4 or 5 tracks, so that if I want to do it live or anything like that, there's a connection in it. You know, something that goes all the way through it. There's too many people. I want to do tracks with a lot of my mates as well, like from famous bands in England, if they'll have me. You know, get a few people from, I don't know, I'm not even going to say names, but yeah, from some of the 90s bands and stuff. Guitarists, bass players, singers. And I'd like to do some collaborations with a few of my mates, you know, as the tracks around this vocalist. So, yeah, I want to do something that's fucking listenable, not DJ stuff, you know. I'm more into writing music that you can keep listening to.
Great news.
So, but it will be tough. Yeah. All about the beats for me again, but, you know, yeah, I'm just really looking forward to that. I don't know if I'll do a live show. I do think about it, because if you wait till you hear the last 2 albums, really, because they're, like I said, there's chill out stuff and hard stuff, old rave stuff. So there's 40 tracks that I've done last year that I can make a live set out of easy, you know, and if I do another album. So I'm doing everything on Bandcamp at the moment. I'm not interested in Spotify or any of that stuff. It's just kind of just nice to feel free to do what I want, put it out when I want. You know, otherwise you've got a record label, it's like, oh man, I've done this track. They're like, yeah, we've got 3 more releases to put out, scheduled, so yours come out in 6 months or 5 months. You're like, yeah, but I won't even like it by then.
Yeah, exactly.
Well, no, I won't like it, but it's kind of, man, I want to do it because I'm playing it now and it's fucking rocking the dance floor, and, you know, so I can do that now and I can just put it out tomorrow if I want.
Yeah.
You know, so it's great. Yeah, I don't think so.
Yeah,
I don't think so. I mean, I don't know what they're doing. To be honest with you, I don't. It's like a secret agent. What I don't know, I can't tell anyone.
Oh, yeah.
Yes, and I have to be like that because,
yeah.
I don't say, a few months back, well, 6 months. Last year, some guy from England was a mate, he said, I'm doing this podcast and I have a chat with you. So yeah, all right. So I said a couple of things, and the next thing, it was in the daily newspaper the next day.
No.
Yeah, you know, and it's like, then Liam's like, man, what you doing that for? What'd you talk to them for? I'm like, dude, mate, I live in Germany for 8 years. They used to come all our gigs backstage and ask me for a podcast, and he's fucking, that's in the daily paper. You know, it's like they've twisted all my words and everything, you know,
The new album and it's all.
I'm hanging out with Maxim the other day, and I'm like, what are you up to and all that? I don't even talk about the band.
Yeah.
You know, so I'm doing some art and I'm doing this, I've got a couple of people recording some music. Like, Liam, what are you up to? Yeah, I'm in the studio, messing around, bits and pieces, been out with the boy and the busy, so da da da. Yeah, what should you look up for dinner? Yeah, you're coming down this way, and that's it.
Great.
It's
like, it should
be like this. Yeah, my mind is like, if I don't know nothing, I can't live. Again, I'm a bit old school. That was kind of what I'd done then, you know. It's like Liam's music made me feel like that. You know, it's the same. It was the same with Keith. He didn't walk around being scary all the time. When you got on stage, we had a license to just explode and be who you want. You're like, wow. You know, there's not lots of stuff that makes me feel like that, you know.
Yeah.
I'm 51 years old. And to be honest, that's a bit of a modern thing. You know, DJs who have superstars, rock stars that are bigger than, they're bigger than the bands, you know. It's EDM shit, you know. It's like, man, you know, the only plan I've put is music, man. I don't want to jump up on the decks and start shouting down a mic for all. If you're playing your own music and it's part of your performance, I kind of get it. But fucking anyone can DJ.
Yeah.
You know, it's like, dude, you know, I don't feel comfortable. Like, you know, yeah, I don't feel comfortable thinking, right, playing someone else's record, then I'm going to go out there and start rocking to it.
Yeah.
It's like, man, I'm here to make you rock.
Yeah,
That's my job. It's not my show. I'm just DJing.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? I've got to make you rock. That's my job. You know, I mean, every now and again, if everyone used to get drunk, I'd go out there and have a little shuffle about and stuff. But, you know, it's kind of like, yeah.
All right.
I'm more comfortable making you rock, you know? Oh man, always good, really friendly people. I like them. Obviously, I keep coming back when I get asked, you know. It's great, man, great country, friendly people,
great
food. And the dance floor, yeah, the dance floor is always lively, you know. I like it when people understand what I do, you know. They get it. I'm not, like I say, I don't just do normal stuff. I make an effort to play things they know and hard energy stuff, you know. And I feel that come back to me in the response, you know, and that's what it's all about. So yeah, it's cool, man. Really cool.
Great, man. Thank you so much.